So welcome, Bob.
Today we're going to discuss a little bit about your role within the Handball community. I might start off by asking about your position.
Thanks, Giordano. Thanks for this opportunity. My position is Executive Director of the Australian Handball Council. The Handball Council is affiliated and made up of three state associations, the New South Wales, the Victorian and the South Australian Handball Council. They're in charge of controlling handball in their own states, but we've joined together as an Australian Handball Council to conduct the Australian National Champions 1, 2, 3, 1, 4, 1.
Okay, so we're going to learn a little bit about your position within the community. Maybe you can tell us a bit about your background and how you became involved.
Well, before I sort of go back to the background of how I became involved, which was through the Christian Brothers Schools, I just want to sort of run back to way back at the 1850s when handball first came to Australia. Basically through the Irish immigrants that came to Australia. And back those days, handball was played against any wall they could find. It was a poor man's game to a degree. In fact, they were played at hotels, on the side of hotels, and it became a bit of a rough man's game when gambling was involved. It fell very short of the law and it was banned at some stage. Luckily, it cleaned itself up. Gambling was cut out of it and the game progressed.
So now that we've talked a little bit about how handball's been played throughout the earlier century, maybe you could go on a bit more about how it's been played and changed throughout the 21st century.
Yeah, it's interesting, Giordano. We had our peak and everything was going well, but other sports started sort of capturing the image. We had more publicity around the place with TV and overseas sports. So a lot of our juniors that we were capturing at the schools seemed to filter away a bit, being lured by the basketball, Australia's rules, of course, were always there. So our numbers started dwindling, unfortunately, and the carnival atmosphere was still great, but the numbers weren't there to keep that sort of game going with over 40s and over 50s and juniors. So the Australian Handball Council got together in the about 2008 or around that time, and with the numbers dropping so much at this carnival once a year and other events, that we decided to change to an open championships, not so much team dominated, to give our players a more scope of their individual ability. And it has worked. The numbers from 2009 when we converted have increased in one wall, three wall and four wall. All four, three games have come forward in numbers and playing. It's on the way up, which is good. How much further we can go, we need people to keep pushing this game. Hopefully we can. You can talk to God, go banging on his door. You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock. You can move a mountain, you can break rocks. You can be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you can find yourself. Standing in the Hall of Fame. Yeah. And the world. You can run the mile, you can walk straight through hell with a smile. You could be the hero, you could get the gold. Breaking all the records they thought never could be broke. Yeah, do it for your people, do it for your pride. And you're never gonna know if you never even try. Do it for your country, do it for your name. Cause there's gonna be a day when you're standing in the Hall of Fame. Yeah.
Bob, maybe you can tell us about these courts, the history behind it, and where you can see the game going from here.
Well, this is Australian handball. This is what it's all about, really. This is our roots to the game. Three-wall handball has been. These particular courts were here in 1955. They fell down, and the colleagues rebuilt them, which is fantastic. And they've been our background. European handball, one-wall handball, is now a real world sport. Three-wall handball, as you can see, is a big court, and to reproduce this and to keep this going is going to be very hard. This will continue in South Australia and Australia, but if we get on the world stage, we have to verify it. versatile with one ball and four ball. We love to keep this game going. Where handball will be in the future, it relies on people involved in the game now to make sure that the last 100 years grows to another 100 years.
Thanks, Bob. We might just start off, I just followed on from Bob, your experience with handball and how you sort of got into the sport.
Yep, so I went to this college here, Ross Trevor, and played on the three courts behind us, and pretty much growing up, you couldn't really play on the course until you were in year 10. It used to be year 10, 11, year 12 on the three courts, so me and a couple of mates used to get here really early before school, come up even on Fridays and on weekends in year 9 and started playing, and then as we progressed through older year levels, we started playing before school, lunchtime, recess time, after school, and even on weekends before footy and after footy. So it was really just playing with your mates. And then after we finished, we caught up with the older handballers that were playing, and one of them in particular, Damien Walk, played football with my dad, and we had an association there, and he invited me out, and I started playing pennant probably at the age of about 16 and playing.
Yeah, that sounds great. How would you say the game's changed for you?
Certainly at school, just playing with your mates and having a bit of fun on the weekends, and then actually as it got a bit older and then started travelling, in particular at Easter time with the state team and playing against the interstate, there was quite a bit of rivalry there, so I became a little bit more serious. And then I have always had a very strong competition rivalry with Jim Cormier, you know, and so when you step on the court against those guys, it really steps up a level. So at times, you know, some weekends we play and it's more social and fun, and other weekends it's pretty intense and serious and you just hate losing.
So you've told us a little bit about how you got involved into the handball community, and you've told us a little bit about how it's changed for you. What would you say it's meant to you to be a proper, you know, a top handball player like you are?
Yes. It's been a massive part of my life. I've played a lot of different sports, and this has probably been one of the real constants that I play. Well, I had since I was young and all year round, pretty much. And one thing it has done for me is playing in a state and formed some great friendships and great rivalries. But also, I've travelled the world and played in two of the world titles in Edmonton and Portland. My brother lives in Manhattan. I've played just locally in the streets down there because there's 2,000 courts in Manhattan. I just love playing with the local kids and guys there in pickup games. So it's actually been a real massive part of my life, and I expect will continue to be so until, you know, I can't walk.
Well, it'll be great to see you out in the court today. Thank you for joining us, and I appreciate your time.
No worries.